हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम बैक टू द मैथ्स सेशन. आई एम हियर योर जसदीप मैम फ्रॉम द लिटिल स्टार स्कूल. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 9, एक्सरसाइज 7.4 फ्रॉम द पेज नंबर 154, ग्राफिक एक्सरसाइज for 3/6 of an hour. Okay. From an hour, yes, exercise this kind, this fraction 3/6. While Rohit exercised for 3/4 of an hour. He has also exercised for an hour. We have to compare it. Right. So, but he has exercised 3/4. Who exercised for a longer time? We have to see that. Okay, first is right. Rafik exercised for 3/6 fraction, and Rohit exercised for 3/4. As you can see, denominators are different, means they are unlike fraction, right? This sum has two ways of solution. You can solve it by two ways. One is if you write 3/6 and here you write 3/4. As I have told, the denominators are different, means it is unlike fraction. But two types of unlike fractions we have studied in, where numerators are same. So, these are the unlike fractions where numerators are same. So, I have told that when numerators are same and denominators are different, at that time, the smaller denominator is the greater fraction, right? So, it becomes like this. So, 3/6 was of Rafik, and 3/4 was of Rohit. So here you have to write who exercised for a longer time. So longer time we got Rohit. So Rohit exercised for a longer time. That we'll write the statement. But we have one more thing. As they are unlike fraction, 3/6 and 3/4. What we can do? We will make them first like fraction, right? 6 and 4. So we'll do first with 2. 2 threes are 2 twos are. In 2 table 3 is not coming. We'll write like that way only. 2 ones are. And then 3 ones are. 2 twos are 4. And 4 twos are. 4 threes are 12. So LCM we got 12. Right? Okay, so for getting 12, what I'll multiply? I'll multiply by 2, right? So in numerator also I'll multiply by 2. 3 2's are 6. 6 2's are 12. 3/4. I'll multiply by 3. So I'll get 12, right? So in numerator also I'll multiply by 3. 3 3's are 9. So we got 6/9, and here we got 6/9, and here we got 9/12. 6/12 and 9/12, right? We got this. Now when denominators are same, means they are like fraction, and when denominators are same, So the greater numerator is a greater fraction, right? Bigger one. So here we have written. So as you can see, 6 upon 12. 6 upon 12 means 3 upon 6. So 3 upon 6 is of Rafik. And 9 upon 12. Here we have took out it of 3 upon 4 fraction. Equivalent fraction we have took out it. So 3 upon 4 is of Rohit. So here it is Rohit. So as you can see that. Here also the answer came same. So there are two ways of solving this sum. And in the end you will write the statement. What you will write? What they have asked? Who exercised for a longer time? So you will write Rohit exercised for a longer time. Okay. In question number 10, the question is, in class A of 25 students, so okay, we'll write, class A is of how many students? 25 students. Passed with 60% or more marks. So here we'll write passed with 60% or more is equals to how many students are there? 20, right? In another class B of 30 students, now class B of 30 students, passed with 60% or more marks. So okay, passed with 60% or more is equals to how much? How many passed? 24. So we'll write 24 students. Okay. In which class was a greater fraction of student getting with 60% or more marks? Question mark. So how we'll get to know? They have told the fraction, greater fraction. For that we have to convert the students into the fraction, right? So in A, twenty-five students were there. So that we'll write in denominator because total was 25. And 20 passed with 60 or more. So we'll write here 20. Now in class B, 30 students were there. So we'll write in denominator 30 because it is a total. And 24 students passed with 60% or more. So 24. What you can see? 20 upon 25, 24 upon 30. All are different. Means they are unlike fraction. Right? So you would be thinking that we have to convert unlike fraction into the like fraction, right? But see it properly. 20 upon 25. You can see the numbers are big. They are not written into the simplest form. So this fraction we can convert into the simplest form. Yes? So we'll do that only. We'll convert this fraction into the simplest form because it is not given into the simplest form. First we'll convert that. So in unit place 0 is there and here it, in unit place 5 is there. What we will do? It is divisible by 5. So 5 4s are and 5 5s are. So here we got the answer 4 upon 5. This was of A. Now next is 24 upon 30. 24 upon 30. Both are coming in which table? Both are coming in 6 table, 2 table, right? But we will see the 6 tables. 6 fours are and 6 fives are. So what we got the answer? 4 upon 5, right? And here we got the answer of B. But in question it was written, in which class was a greater fraction of students getting with 60% or more marks? But here we can see that in both class, how many fraction of students are getting 60% or more? In both class they are getting. Because in A also 4 upon 5 and in B also 4 upon 5. Right? So our answer will be, what will be our answer? Our answer in both classes, fraction of students getting with 60% or more marks are equal, right? They both are equal. That thing only we have written in the statement. Okay. Now with this sum we have completed exercise 7.4. Now we will start a new concept. Please keep on revising the previous concept. And now we will start a new concept.